Good evening. I'd like to go ahead and call this meeting to order of the Guthrie Public Schools Board of Education for Monday, September 11th, 2023. Would you please call the roll?
Smedley?
Here.
Girard?
Here.
Schroeder?
Here.
Pearson? Salee?
Here.
Davis?
Here.
Plack?
Here.
Mr. President, we have a quorum.
Thank you. Stand and please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. As we begin this meeting, let us pause for a moment of silence. Thank you. This time, employee and student recognitions.
Mr. President, we are going to honor those recipients next month due to some issues that we've had obtaining some of the things that we need to make those presentations. We're going to delay that, and we will honor for 2 months in October.
Okay. Item 7 is comments to the board by citizens registered to speak to the board.
We have none.
Okay. By any board members? All right. Item 8, the superintendent's report.
Thank you, Mr. President. We've had a very smooth start to the school year, and then even today, you can tell that it's time for the state fair, and we've got the county fairs over with because we have rain. And so you can pretty much always plan on that eventually. You know, today certainly provides us with memories of the fateful day 22 years ago, and that's been, I know that's been on many people's minds and certainly on mine today. Next, I want to recognize, and he's not here because he's at an event, but our athletic director, John Chappell, for his quick thinking and having an AED on hand at our softball field as a medical event occurred. After many days in the hospital, the person experiencing the event has been discharged and is continuing to recover. And so we are very happy to know that, and very appreciative of Mr. Chappell and the parents and people that were trained to operate that AED, as they provided life-saving measures in advance of the EMTs arriving. Little update on our enrollment. We currently have 3,506 students enrolled as of this morning, and that's 51 more than we had at this time last year. We also currently have 50 students that are attending on a transfer. Most of those were approved last year or approved historically. Something that I know is on the minds of a lot of our high school students, at least, and our high school staff. If it's not, it will be in full force by tomorrow. But America's Greatest High School Homecoming is this week, and the Alumni Assembly is Friday morning, and the parade scheduled for 3 o'clock p.m. Kickoff against Tuttle is at 7 p.m. at the Rock. School will be dismissed at 2:10 p.m., and buses will run at that time. Message for the board members, the OSSBA has a Region 6 meeting scheduled for Thursday, October 5th at the OSSBA Conference Center. If you'd like to attend, please let Samantha know so that we can get you registered. And my last item, our condolences certainly go out to the family of Brooklyn High, a high school junior who we lost on August 31st. I, along with Mr. Throckmorton, have spent time with the family, and I'm very proud of how our team went into crisis mode on that day, along with the days that followed, to be present for our students and staff.
Thank you, Dr. Simpson. At this time, we're going to have a presentation of the Guthrie Public Schools Dropout Report for 2021-2022 by Mr. John Hancock, Executive Director of Personnel and Secondary Education.
All right, thank you, President, Dr. Simpson. This is about our 21-22. The reason why our dropout report isn't for 22-23 is because those students still have a chance to complete until October 1. So that's kind of why we're down 2 years. You know, from 2 years ago, we talked, we had a total of what I would consider, if you look at this, would be 12 dropouts, or what they would consider as dropouts because they exited to homeschool or unknown, or two of them just absolutely stated that they weren't going to return to school. But we did finish out with 241 students that year that were in seventh grade. Those students are now in ninth grade. Our eighth graders, at that time, we had 25 leave to go to other state schools. Two exited to homeschool as well. One immigrated back to their country. We had 18 that are unknown that would be considered as dropouts as well. So 20 with 251 finishing out that school year. And the ninth grade, this would be our juniors right now. We had 36 students that went to another school in Oklahoma or another state. One immigrated back as well. Two homeschool students, I'm sorry, I meant to put six out of state, six dropout. Of those, 19 students have returned back to classes and are attending the high school at this time. We finished off with 288 students.
It's a big class.
Your sophomores, which would be seniors now, we had 40 that exited to another diploma issuing school. One of those returned back to their home country. Three of them moved out of state. Five were unknown. Six are considered as dropouts. We had 292 students finish out that year. These students were your graduates from last year that would have been on this. They had 36 that went to another school, one homeschool, nine of them considered dropouts, four unknown, which meant that they could have went somewhere else. But we had 253 finished out the school year. And then this year's what they would consider the cohort. You had 14 exit to other schools. You had three dropouts completely. 223 of these students graduated. Seven finished out the year without enough credits to be considered as graduates. One foreign exchange student, and then one of them aged out at the age of 20. So that would be our dropout report for this year.
Questions, Mr. Hancock?
Thank you. Item 10 on our agenda this evening is the approval of the consent agenda.
Mr. President, I move that we approve the consent agenda.
Second.
There's been a motion and a second to approve the consent agenda. Any further discussion at this time? Roll call vote, please.
Smedley?
Yes.
Girard?
Yes.
Schroeder?
Yes.
Salee?
Yes.
Davis?
Yes.
Flagg?
Yes.
Six ayes, zero nays.
Motion passes. Item 11 on our business agenda, item A, is the recommendation, consideration, and action upon the gifted and talented committee.
This is an item that we bring to you annually for approval as required by the State Department and by law. Page 74 are the recommendations for that committee. And Ms. Young, again, will chair that, and we recommend approval.
Mr. President,
I move that we approve the Gifted and Talented Committee.
Second.
There's been a motion to approve the Gifted and Talented Committee. Any further discussion? Roll call vote, please.
Smedley?
Yes.
Girard?
Yes.
Schroeder?
Yes.
Salee?
Yes.
Davis?
Yes.
Flagg?
Yes.
Six ayes, zero nays.
Motion passes. Item 11B is the recommendation, consideration, and action upon Professional Development Committee for 2023-2024.
Our recommendations are on page 75 of your board packet. Very similar situation to the Gifted and Talented Committee. There are teachers, administrators, and parents that serve on these committees, and we recommend approval.
Mr. President, I make a motion that we approve the Professional Development Committee for 2023-2024.
Second.
There's been a motion and a second to approve the Professional Development Committee for 2023-2024. Any further discussion? Roll call vote, please.
Smedley?
Yes.
Girard?
Yes.
Schroeder?
Yes.
Salee?
Yes.
Davis?
Yes.
Flag?
Yes.
Six ayes, zero nays.
Motion passes. Item 11C is the recommendation, consideration, and action upon choosing the ACT as the district high school academic assessment for 2023-2024 school year.
We are required annually to form a committee to discuss whether or not the test that we give is either the ACT or the SAT. Students can still take whichever test they prefer on a national test date, but the test that we administer in the spring, we are required to meet to discuss that and reach a conclusion. And the conclusion is once again to administer the ACT this spring. The committee that Mr. Hancock headed up there, you'll see, is on page 76 of your board packet, and we would recommend approval.
Mr. President, I make a motion to approve the ACT as the district's high school academic assessment for the 2023 to 2024 school year.
Second.
There's been a motion and a second to approve the ACT as the district high school academic assessment for 2023-2024 school year. Any further discussion on this? Roll call vote, please.
Smedley?
Yes.
Girard?
Yes.
Schroeder?
Yes.
Chalee?
Yes.
Davis?
Yes.
Flag?
Yes.
Six ayes, zero nays.
Motion passes. Item 11D is the recommendation, consideration, and action to approve the transcription of math and science credit options taught at Meridian Technology Center.
This is an annual item that we bring to the board. The board is required to act on this so that a math or science class that is taken at Meridian can be transcripted to Guthrie High School, and it requires board approval to do that. Many of our students will take, because of the nature of their schedule, they will be in a situation where they need to take either the math or the science class at Meridian, and then the remainder of their credits that are not on the career tech schedule, but core classes will be Guthrie High School class. And we recommend approval of this.
Mr. President, I make a motion that we approve the transcription of math and science credit options taught at Meridian Technology Center.
Second.
There's been a motion and a second to approve the transcription of math and science credit options taught at Meridian Technology Center. Any further discussion? Roll call vote, please.
Smedley?
Yes.
Girard?
Yes.
Schroeder?
Yes.
Chalee?
Yes.
Davis?
Yes.
Flag?
Yes.
Six ayes, zero nays.
Motion passes. Item 11E is the recommendation, consideration, and action upon 2023-2024 estimate of needs as prepared by Putnam & Company, PLLC, and 23-24 financial statement and the authority to publish the same.
Pages 78 through 128 of your board packet has our estimate of needs as prepared by our auditors. And Dr. Chappell, is there anything you'd like to add to this before we open it up, if there are any questions?
Yeah.
Any questions for Dr. Chappell? One item that I would call your attention to, if I can find it, I found it earlier. Page, Michelle, what page is the millage on? You know, offhand? 15.8 is where the millage is right now, and that is a product of the growing net assessed valuation within our school district. Because remember, our target for sinking fund millage was 17, and that has that is dropping because of the fact that we have more net assessed valuation that is taxable. So that is that's a good thing. We've, you know, remember from School Finance 101, that is a positive for our district. From the building fund perspective, it increases the money that goes into our building fund, and from the general fund perspective, it reduces our reliance on state aid, which is, as we can remember from the dark days of the Oklahoma economy, subject to loss, and provides us a much more stable funding mechanism. So that's good news. Thank you. Ooh, I was a long ways from there.
Mr. President, I make a motion that we approve the 2023-2024 estimate of needs as prepared for by Putnam & Company, PLLC, and the 2023-2024 financial statement and the authority to publish the same.
Second.
There's been a motion and a second to approve the 2023-2024 estimate of needs as prepared by Putnam & Company, PLLC, and 2023-2024 financial statement and the authority to publish the same. Any further discussion? Roll call vote.
Smedley?
Yes.
Girard?
Yes.
Schroeder?
Yes.
Salee?
Yes.
Davis?
Yes.
Flag?
Yes.
6 ayes, 0 nays.
Motion passes. Item 11F is the recommendation, consideration, and action on the following appointment for 2023-2024. Stephanie Simmons, Assistant Treasurer.
You'll remember that we left this position blank when the board approved the slate of other staff members to be appointed because we had not filled it yet. But since then, we have filled it with Ms. Simmons and recommend that she be appointed Assistant Treasurer.
Mr. President, I make a motion we appoint Stephanie Simmons, Assistant Treasurer for 2023-2024.
Second.
There's a motion and a second to appoint Stephanie Simmons as the Assistant Treasurer for 2023-2024. Any further discussion? Roll call vote, please.
Smedley?
Yes.
Girard?
Yes.
Schroeder?
Yes.
Salee?
Yes.
Davis?
Yes.
Flag?
Yes.
6 ayes, 0 nays.
Motion passes. Item 11G is the recommendation, consideration, and action upon contract with the Stacy Group, Incorporated for architectural services for 2023-2024.
It's an annual item that we bring to the board for ratification. It's hard to believe this. We finished 10 years now with the Stacy Group. And Gail, I know you were probably a part of this original selection. We feel very pleased with the work that they're doing for us and would recommend that we renew the agreement with them.
Mr. President, I make a motion that we approve the contract with the Stacy Group for architectural services for 2023-24.
Second.
There's a motion and a second to approve the contract with the Stacy Group Incorporated for architectural services for 2023-2024. Any further discussion?
Mr. Salee was a part of it as well.
A long time ago.
Roll call vote, please.
Smedley?
Yes.
Girard?
Yes.
Schroeder?
Yes.
Salee?
Yes.
Davis?
Yes.
Flag?
Yes.
6 ayes, 0 nays.
Motion passes. Item 11H is the recommendation, consideration, and action to ratify the agreement with Synergistic LLC for energy management assessment.
You'll remember that this is I believe it's a five-year program, but we are required to annually renew this, and so we bring this to you for ratification, and I would anticipate sometime probably in the spring that we will bring them in for at least at the committee level, but possibly for the board level again for a report to provide an update on how things are going. But this is more of a formality here as we continue to see savings with our energy management system.
Mr. President, I make a motion that we approve the agreement with Synergistic LLC for energy management assessment.
Second.
There's a motion and a second to approve the agreement with Synergistic LLC for energy management services assessment. Any further discussion? Roll call vote, please.
Smedley?
Yes.
Girard?
Yes.
Schroeder?
Yes.
Salee?
Yes.
Davis?
Yes.
Flag?
Yes.
6 ayes, 0 nays.
Motion passes. Item 11I is the recommendation, consideration, and action on District Policy F5, Transfers Exhibit A.
State law requires that we visit this quarterly and in advance of the October 1st date to re-ratify our transfer capacities, and I would recommend that we keep them as we have them with everything that's listed on page F5 Exhibit A, which is on page 147 of your board packet.
Is
Mr. President, I make a motion that we approve District Policy F5, Transfers, Exhibit A.
Second.
There's been a motion and a second to approve District Policy F5, Transfers, Exhibit A. Any more discussion? Roll call vote, please.
Smedley.
Yes.
Girard.
Yes.
Schroeder.
Yes.
Salee.
Yes.
Davis.
Yes.
Flag.
Yes.
6 ayes, 0 nays.
Motion passes. Item 12 is the proposed executive session for the purpose of discussing employment and personnel, FMLA request, resignation, separation from employment, and transfer position request, all set out on the personnel reports. Extra duty assignments is listed for 2023-2024. Discussing purchase or appraisal of real property and periodic annual evaluation in terms of employment of Dr. Michael Simpson, Superintendent of Schools. Disclosure of which information would violate the confidentiality requirements of state and or federal law, all pursuant to 25 Oklahoma Statute, Section 307, B1, 3, and 7.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
There's been a motion and a second. Roll call vote, please.
Smedley.
Yes.
Girard.
Yes.
Schroeder.
Yes.
Salee.
Yes.
Davis.
Yes.
Flag.
Yes.
6 ayes, 0 nays.
Motion passes. Okay, only items in agenda number 12 were discussed in executive session and no votes were taken. This shall constitute the executive session minutes. Item 13 is the vote on the personnel reports.
Mr. President, I make a motion we approve the personnel reports.
Second.
There's a motion and a second to approve the personnel reports. Roll call vote, please.
Smedley.
Yes.
Girard.
Yes.
Schroeder.
Yes.
Salee.
Yes.
Davis.
Yes.
Flag.
Yes.
6 ayes, 0 nays.
Motion passes. Item 14 is action upon recommendation of extra duty assignments as listed for 2023-2024.
Mr. President, I make a motion that we approve the extra duty assignments as listed for 2023-2024.
Second.
There's a motion and a second to approve the extra duty assignments as listed for 2023-2024. Roll call vote, please.
Smedley.
Yes.
Girard.
Yes.
Schroeder.
Yes.
Salee.
Yes.
Davis.
Yes.
Flag.
Yes.
6 ayes, 0 nays.
Motion passes. Item 15 is a recommendation, consideration, and action upon approval Levi Casey to be classified as an adjunct teacher for Algebra 1 at Guthrie High School.
Mr. President, I make a motion we approve Levi Casey to be classified as an adjunct teacher for Algebra 1 at Guthrie High School.
Second.
There's been a motion and a second to approve Levi Casey to be classified as adjunct teacher for Algebra 1 at Guthrie High School. Roll call vote, please.
Smedley.
Yes.
Girard.
Yes.
Schroeder.
Yes.
Salee.
Yes.
Davis.
Yes.
Flag.
Yes.
6 ayes, 0 nays.
Motion passes. Item 16 is the recommendation, consideration, and action upon approval of William Daves to be classified as adjunct teacher, Algebra 2 at Guthrie High School.
Mr. President, I make a motion that we approve William Daves to be classified as an adjunct teacher, Algebra 2 at Guthrie High School.
Second.
There's a motion and a second to approve William Daves to be classified as adjunct teacher, Algebra 2 at Guthrie High School. Roll call vote, please.
Smedley.
Yes.
Girard.
Yes.
Schroeder.
Yes.
Salee.
Yes.
Davis.
Yes.
Flag.
Yes.
6 ayes, 0 nays.
Motion passes. Item 17 is the recommendation, consideration, and action to accept any resignations offered since the posting of the agenda.
We have none.
Item 18 is the discussion and possible action on new business not known about or could not have been reasonably foreseen at the time of the agenda posting.
We have none.
Item 19 is adjournment.
So move.
Second.
Roll call vote, please.
Smedley.
Yes.
Girard.
Yes.
Schroeder.
Yes.
Salee.
Yes.
Davis.
Yes.
Flag.
Yes.
6 ayes, 0 nays.
Motion passes. This meeting is adjourned.